Anaesthetics is the largest hospital branch of medicine, actually, but it's usually the one people know the least about because it seems very much behind the scenes. One of the great honours of doing anaesthetics is if you can get somebody to trust you with their life within a few minutes of meeting them, you've done a good job already. I am an ACCS anaesthetics trainee. ACCS stands for Accute Care Common Stem, which is a three-year core training program for junior doctors after their foundation years. Nobody in my family's been to university. I think I was the first person to even sit A-levels. I always knew I wanted to go to university. I always wanted to be a doctor, but I knew it was very difficult to get into medical school, so I thought it would be a challenge. The sixth form I went to weren't used to sending students to medical school. I don't think they'd done so for 9 years. So I didn't get in first time out of sixth form. I instead went to a different university to do undergraduate biomedical science. I spent a year working as a microbiologist in a lab and actually reaching out to people who had connections to the NHS, mostly about the structure of the NHS and the whole point of medicine and the whole point of the NHS is you've got many, many branches all working together. And I think that Hull York is that sort of medical school where it is very holistic. You are thinking about the whole and the many parts within it. So for that reason, I think we were a good fit. Anaesthetics is a specialty that I'd heard about for people to sleep for operations. So when I was at Hull York Medical School, they had student selected components, and so you can try a different hat on for a couple of weeks, or you can really get deeply involved in a medical specialty that you like, for example, or a research project that you liked. And when I was in York and Scarborough, there were these student selected components for operating theatres and for anaesthetics. So I spent 2 weeks in each over the space of a year, and they were very friendly. The consultants were very welcoming to all the medical students into that environment and very encouraging in allowing us to shadow them when they were on call and to assist with them in the operating theatre. It just seems like such a nice environment that got me thinking more about it. Something I really liked about Hull York was the focus on communication skills from day one. It's actually something that I struggled with before I came to medical school. I am quite shy when I first meet people. I'm not very good at small talk. I didn't think that I was very good at building rapport. So learning tips and tricks from practicing doctors when you're just starting medical school gives you a lot of confidence very quickly. And the sheer amount of practice you get over 5 years before you graduate means that you hit the ground running when you actually start working as a doctor. Because when you're doing anaesthetics, you are meeting somebody for the first time, maybe half an hour before their operation, which may be the scariest day of their life so far. Those few minutes of talking to them and explaining and reassuring and answering those questions, that's something that I take real pride in doing well.